welcome to this episode of Long and Hard. So off screen, we went through our gear, made a few changes, got some better stuff here, but we lucked out and found something with Kodama Sense. This is the thing that makes the little mushrooms show up on the map, so we're kind of going to be cheating with that. So hopefully I don't miss anything that way. And yeah, beyond that, I think we're ready to go to the next level. I thought we were ready for the next region. It's a region, not continent, but the next area, but we have to go through this level first. I forgot it was here. And after this, I think it's to the next region. Oh yeah, I also crafted some water talismans for the bosses of this level. That is the element they are weak to, I believe. I'll let this play out here. Was the bunny rabbit? Anyways, here we are in what is half of a very glorious level of just tons of rain. Right, altar. Oh, wait, before I forget, we need to actually equip our water talismans here. Hopefully that guy doesn't see us while we're doing this. And replace the fire, because we want to save them for a particularly nasty fight later on. Water, here we go. We also have a spear now, so we can start raking in those proficiency points with the spear. Spear is one of those weapons that's significantly worse without skills, so not gonna be super great here, but it's still a fun little weapon. It's really easy to kind of clink on the walls, though, until you get a certain perk that, unfortunately, is a level 1 run, we won't be able to do, because they're in the dojo, there's a bunch of training missions that, after you complete, unlock skills, and you have to meet certain prerequisites with your stats. And we won't be meeting those, unfortunately.
Anything back here?
So it is going to make the game a bit rougher, because a lot of the really useful passive perks and whatnot we just won't ever have access to, unless we put points in, level up, and then unspec after we've done the training missions, but it doesn't feel right, you know? We're here to do a proper level 1 run, and that means, sadly, it's not going to have those perks and skills. Oh, well. I just got patient there, I don't know why. No matter how far in, even when you do have gear, every enemy is dangerous. So you do have to be careful about that. I should dodge out of here. They're just throwing bombs at us left and right over there. We'll deal with him shortly, though. That hurt something. I don't know what he's doing, he just keeps jumping back. Oh, don't worry, I don't know what we're doing either, buddy. We can knock this tree down, it's a little shortcut for the water. There's a couple of goodies down there, I don't think there's a Kodama. Well, if there is, we'll see him on the map now that we have cheater technology. Our radar has improved. The wall there. When we go underground at the second half of this level, I'm going to unequip the spear immediately. It is not something you want to use in tight corners, so enjoy it while we can here, you know what I mean? Oh, yeah. Ninjas can be extremely obnoxious. especially in groups. Later on, you can fight like three of them at the same time. I just like to kind of back up and use the really unfair parry skill with the sword to immediately kill them, but I don't know if we can actually parry because we don't have a lot of stamina. That's for sure. Can got a skill point. Come out of there, you dick. Alright. Got a little penis-y, but it paid off. It panned out. We sting like a bee with this little poking stick, you know? Uh-oh. Someone sees me. Oh, there he is. Then we'll just poke him again for good measure. Spirit stones, those are the XP souls, basically, from Dark Souls. As similar as this game is, I really do like all the differences it has. It's similar while really being its own thing. Also, we have a cannon here because they do the most ranged damage. We like bigger numbers. It is, of course, the slowest, and you can't move while using it, but as someone who is using a Steam controller, we don't exactly plan on using it very often anyway, so. Yeah. One of these days, I'll get an actual decent gamepad here for computer games. I had one, but the 360 controller, but unfortunately, much like the 360, it went up in smoke. Speaking of that, anyone out there had the Red Ring of Death? Oh boy, is that a fun thing. Really common, too. Ow. I'm just talking about old gaming systems that are terrible and these guys are beating the crap out of me. How rude. We get a poke in the butt. And we get to accidentally use that. As I mentioned earlier, this is probably the best living weapon. It just has so much range and speed, and I did not do it just cheese on that. Alright. I kinda thought that would last longer, but we just got hit and that ruined it. Oh, these little buggers. If you let them eat your XP, they'll turn into a Cyclops, and they can be annoying to hit. Also, I haven't actually been looking at the map for Kodama's. I remember there was one over here and totally missed it. You can even see it on the map, it's that little green dot. Just gonna do a quick little run around here while looking at the map. I think we're good. Pretty sure there's two more up here. I don't know. Unfortunately, after we're done in this small little awesome rainy courtyard, we go underground into like a Hellboy-like maze. If you've seen the second Hellboy, it's very similar to that with the army of statues. And of course that Hellboy movie is based off a Chinese thing, folklore. Might actually have some semblance in reality. I'm not super caught up on Chinese history. I only know what Dynasty Warriors taught me, and somehow I don't think that's the most accurate source. We can do the shortcut here. This just takes us to the entrance. So if we die on the first mini-boss here, we can get back to him pretty quickly. Hopefully that won't be an issue. Also, citing Dynasty Warriors as a historical source, very questionable, I'll admit. Very questionable. But, I mean, it covers the bases, right? You got Lu Bu, you got the Warring Dynasties, you got little mushroom people. Maybe not that last part, but be pretty cool if that was a thing. take liberties like the Strike Force version did that just went crazy with stuff and had you basically being like something out of Dragon Ball Z. Keep calling this words elude me. Keep calling the Living Weapon Super Saiyan. Seems fitting to make that connection. Now we have the key to the courtyard, which is where the little mini boss is, and where the last of the amazing rain takes place. And there's a lot of dead people over here. I don't know what these people are doing. I actually kill them and try and get some loot, but it's probably too high level for us at this point. Playing with kind of a weird angle to keep the controller from making sounds, so that's why I occasionally enter aiming unintentionally. Oh, not that mess. I thought I was gonna hit. Alright. We're good. Something sees us. What sees us? Oh. A nifty little trick when you have terrible aiming is if you lock onto an enemy and switch to your gun, it'll automatically start aiming at them. There's a little zombie behind those boxes, but we don't really care too much about him. It's not harming anyone. It's just chilling, enjoying the rain. I can respect that. He's got good taste. Alright, I think we got him all. I know there's a rooftop thing. Yeah, there might actually be hair on the roof. I'm gonna check real quick. We'll zoom up this roof area. This is a bit of a walk. Looks like nothing. Unfortunate. We'll just top off before we fight the boss here. Losing my voice here. Can't say good enough. Say hello to the new. He's gonna kill us. He likes to do lightning. And disappear. Didn't work. Normally when he does that, you can just hit his chest and that blows up on him, but what I didn't take into account was the spear's hitbox. So we're just gonna go ahead and unequip the spear here pretty early. Hit that, I did hit that. Now we're kinda out of stamina, so... Whoops. Be honest, oh. Mistakes. Oh crap. Got penis-y. Alright. This time for sure, no problems. No problems. That was close. To do that telewep, he is definitely a top percentile, whatever he is, little lightning cat monster thing. He's basically a Pokemon. Uh-oh, we're out of key, stamina, whatever. Does his lightning again, we'll use our Super Saiyan and hopefully break his thing. And we can well away on him. Oh, there it is. And... Ah, fast enough. Whatever, we still got it. Well away on him. Those were good. But the debuff that slows us down. Ah, I didn't make it to him in time. I might make it to us though. Nope, he's doing a spin. Also, something worth noting, those yokai realms, the black mist parts, that actually gives demons their key back also. So that's why it's useful to clear them out when you can. Like that, minus the death. Holy crap, how are we still alive? That was sketchy. Wrong. Apparently so are we. That was not intentional. Uh-oh. Yeah, see, he's got his key back just from being in there. Kind of annoying. Could have gotten another hit or two. Uh-oh. Gotta back away. We're playing a little cautiously light right now, because we're kind of close to winning. We got a chance here. Oh. It's being dumb. Oh, this could be it. And finally got it. Oh, jeez. And that is that little bugger right there. All my hate on the Odachi, but to be honest, when you don't have any skills, it's actually pretty good. This part's kind of annoying though, because this little dick kind of blocks you for 2 seconds. Also, if you were wondering if this was made by Team Ninja or not, well, look no further. Even all your mage, I protect this area. Nice to meet you. That creature is my familiar. I'm sorry, why am I reading this? You can. Now you gotta. You gotta. Little jester here. I wonder if it'll work with any blue jester. It does. Okay. I kinda zoned out there for a minute and started skipping. But we got the important text. Also, there is a mushroom right here, which I honestly forgot about. I'm so glad we have the sense. That one's sneaky, you have to just know he's there. He is perfectly out of sight otherwise. And now we enter the Hellboy Chinese armor phase place. It's kind of cool, but it's not raining. Water should be leaking down here, just like little puddles and buildups. Now that would be a level right there. But, I mean, all things considered, I guess this earth design's okay. Do we? No, we don't need anything. Actually, it doesn't matter. There's like a hat we can maybe unlock. It just has a little valve on it because we're using the Steam version. It's kind of funny. It doesn't do anything, and we'd have to wait till we can refashion. And why wouldn't we want to be a knight? This area is, again, a giant maze, and I have no sense of direction whatsoever. I'm just vaguely going off memory here, because there is a mushroom here. After this, I am uncertain of anything. Also, you can use traps against the mushroom. One more time. Ah, can't see. Alright, he just did that one to himself. There is a brief period when they're out of ki that they won't recover ki in those yokai realms though. What is that? Which is nice, because if it was just constant, you would never be able to break them. Go all Rocky Four on him. I'm gonna break you. I'll keep these references coming for the two people out there that might get them. Not that they're even funny to begin with, though. Whatever. Oh, we found the next altar. But we see a little mushroom friend, too. Also, you can actually see in the bottom row we have 3 samurai skill points and 2 ninjutsu, which I kind of learned to zone it out. But if you're wondering what that meant, that's what that means. These guys are much easier if you have fire weapons or damage, but apparently we don't have that, so it's kind of a long fight. I'm gonna skip most of them, but this guy's guarding a mushroom, so. Oh, that would have one-shot us if that hit. We came inches from death, you know. Plus 30% chance to just survive, but ignoring that. Let's look around for these mushrooms anyway. So, as mentioned in the little bit of text, there were some audio issues that made the rest of the video kind of unwatchable. Hopefully that doesn't happen again, but just for the sake of making it all kind of an overall decent quality, we're just gonna redo this level. Not too much has happened since then. After clearing this level originally, I did a little bit of micromanaging on a side mission, which we'll do again. And so that's why we have a little more stamina right now. Our gear's a bit optimized. We put a few of the prestige title points in. And, yeah. Still level 1, of course. Always. Always level 1. That is the point of the run, after all. Here we have our first encounter with And she really won't hold you back at all. She's a monster. She's stronger than us. And kind of a funny thing, there's a mission where she is just with you the whole time. And a lot of people just use that to farm revenants for gear. And also, we have permanent fire scrolls now. I can show you the kind of difference in damage. Maybe not, because she's just gonna sell that. Alright, well, take my word for it. It does a lot of damage when you get the debuff off. Those guys normally are pretty resilient to everything else. But there she is, just being a complete beast. I hate these flame hands so much. See if we can get around this without activating. She might activate. That's close. Oh! That's an armor. I thought he was aiming for her, and I dodged right into it. Pretty quick walk, at least. Walk of shame, though. This little skull's here to enchant our weapons for us. I'm missing. Oh, it's not dying. This guy again shows. Ooh! That's another little element that I haven't mentioned, because it doesn't come up often unless you make it happen, but there's a special debuff that enemies or you can receive if you are under 2 elemental effects at the same time. I think it's called a Discord. Basically, it completely ruins stamina regeneration, and it's very powerful. You can make it work pretty reliably in co-op, or you can use a scroll for your weapon and throw magic at enemies of a different element to try and make it happen. But yeah, if you get it to work, it's really powerful.
You guys got a nice hat. It's not as good as our hat, though. Hey, bro, what's up? See my abs, bro? You could fry an egg on these bad boys. We get a closer look, my man. Alright, she is cock blocking us hard on this one. Trying to have a bro moment. Ooh, he's got red eyes now. He's edgy. It's Baldy. He's back. Hey, Baldy.
I found you.
That was pretty quick, too. How did they not notice the body just lying over there?
I never expected you to follow me all the way to these godforsaken islands.
Give me back what you took, bro.
You will return what you took from me. Now.
Yeah. Alright, here you go.
Sorry.
Imagine if he did just get back then. Liam comes here. Give it back. Alright, here you go. Alright, thanks. Bye. Have fun conquering Japan. Oh, would William care? Kind of. Oh. Hello. Alright, we're in the fight now. What's happening? So this guy's not too bad. He likes to drain his stamina for you. You can just knock him down and poke him. Yeah. Just knock him out. Oh. Doing a quick draw. That was close. Oh yeah. So I kind of, there was a cut you might not have noticed. I take an intentional death here. As we've normally seen this cutscene, and it skips scene cutscene, so I want you guys to bask in the glory of it. Can you break him? Yeah, we're just cheating on this guy. Because, yeah, why not? You can also destroy him with counters, but we don't have... We're just relying on this totally fair method. To be fair, I mean, you do have to dodge that quick draw attack. There we go. Oh. Don't want to be too close because that attack will knock you down instead. So either do that attack or his quick draw. Oh. And we're just gonna chase that all crazy. Yeah, we can cheat and just make a stab somewhere. Oh. Oh crap. Almost lost there. Oh. Ah. Alright, that was. Dropped the ball on that one. But we're doing pretty good. We were doing pretty good. Things just started. Oh! But yeah, that's an attack that Mr. Baldy does, where he grabs you with his red stuff. It's a pretty nasty attack. Oh, we got. Oh, I forgot about that attack. Okay, there's a third attack. So, made a few mistakes at the end. I think we actually did better the first time around. Onwards we go. What will happen? Nobody knows. Pupper! All green puppy dogger.
This spirit guided.
Yeah, that's wrong. Give it back, bro. Stop being a dick. Find your own. Cold dibs. Stop trying to take my sloppy seconds. It's gross, bro. Man, he is taking all that XP. He is power leveling. Stop cheating with your teleporting. Guess we get another feather. I don't really know why we want them, but keeps picking them up. I don't know, it seems like they'd form a line or a segment, really. Ooh. Sword. Ah yeah, swag. Free loot. Take that blade. We got a pink pupper dog while we're at it.
殿が異国に出兵した後、太后秀吉様がやってきました。太后様を拒み、自害したとして、殿は立花の民はどうなるのか。こう失いし我が身、この先長くはありますまい。
Manya, she's happy, I guess. Oh, I'm still mixed on those. There's a bunch of them. We could just skip them. Or maybe I'll put annotations if you want to skip it in the video. Once I learn how to do that. Or did it just duplicate the pink doggo? I think it did. It's OP. We can all just have pink doggos. No. Just have a little pink doggo daycare. Great fun had by everyone. But anyways, so I think this takes us out now. Normally, what you would do from here, I'll splice it in a bit as I'm talking, but this little boat icon unlocks and it takes you to another region.
ウィリアム、官兵殿が船員を手配してくださった。わしは大阪におられる家康様へ石田方の動きを伝えに参る。早速毛利へ向かう長政殿と共にリーフデ号で大阪に向かうことにいたぞ。
This is a voyage. Now, one thing I don't get, is this supposed to be William's original ship? Because I don't think any of the people on it are English. But that's not right. Alright, how are you gonna look at that and tell me it's not a giant dildo? No, what you mean, bro? What you mean? Where'd it go? That's a big, big ass liquid phallic thing. And it's just spewing crap all over the place. Yeah, let's turn around. We're gonna get away from this thing. It's only a giant monster. Alright then, we did get away. It just doesn't care. And that works out for us, to be honest. He was a big boy. Hope we don't have to fight that thing. Bum, bum, bum.
Ayakashi. Uwasa ni kiku umibouzu. Ika ni onushi to de ha ga tatsumai. Leaf demo mo hidoi arisama ja. Hitobazu, aki ni yoru to shiyou.
長政殿は親族にあたる平岡頼勝殿の調略に出向くとのこと。船が修理されるまで身動きは取れぬし、毛利の調略を手伝ってくれ。Ooh, those are nice woods, man. Those are some big ass stairs. You're gonna have like a Rocky training montage on these bad boys. It's the eye of the tiger, it's the thrill of the fight, rising up
to the challenge of our rivals. Yeah, what? As the last known survivor stalks his prey in the night, he's watching us all with the eyes of the tiger. So there's the tiger. Bump, 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 bump. What, bro? You never seen a knight without a shirt before? Get over it. Come on. Fucking pervert. Eyeing my nipples. Shit. You better walk away, boy. You don't want none of this. I don't even want any of this. That's how bad it is. I haven't showered and since we got here. It's been a rough couple weeks. Alright, we don't want him as an enemy. Keep that in mind, guys. That would be bad. Alright, here we are in the Chugoku region. Chugoku, I'm sure I'm pronouncing it wrong. Hopefully with a little editing magic, that didn't seem so bad. Replaced the cutscenes with some newer ones, but kept some of the original footage to keep it cohesive. Anyways, the last thing we did, since all the footage went poopy on us, was clear this. We're gonna knock this bad boy out real quick in just a moment. Just wanna go over some very quick changes. We have better stuff here. We'll equip a better sword. We like that weapon's got decent damage. Another thing worth noting is that little blue bar on the top in the middle, the familiarity. As you use a weapon more and more, that bar fills up. And depending on that rarity determines how much of the bar you can fill on any given weapon. And if you look at all the stats, they're blue. As that bar raises, you get little bonuses to them. So like originally it was something like 166 attack. Maybe like 9 or 8 break, and so on. It can just kind of make gear a bit better. This stuff doesn't actually have familiarity, but normally armor does. I guess this stuff is too low level to have it. But armor normally has it too. There's also an inheritance system and some other crap, but eh, it's all too complicated. Don't worry about it. Anyways, we spent some hair and somewhere in here there's a perk. Aha! And this just gives us a bit more key. We got 5 more key from this. This is one of those things that's passive and applies to all weapons. All the weapon trees have a couple nice things like this. If we have the hair to spare, we might look into it. Anyways, let's go ahead and knock back this little side quest real quick so that we can end this episode properly the way it was originally planned. Minus a few unforeseen technical difficulties. Got a nice, happy, friendly little level here. We fight a couple guys in this arena, get a reward, bada bang, bada boom, you know what I mean? That's the fun people say, for sure. But, we got this happy little background full of people hanging on pikes and stuff. We're just, visiting Uncle Vladimir for the weekend or something, I don't know. I mean, he's a little quirky. It's all good. We all have our quirks. Some people collect things, some people sing. Other people bathe in human blood. I mean, what are you gonna do? Big world. I hate those skulls so much. They just constantly harass you, bump into you, and everything else you don't want. These guys aren't. These Ringu guys aren't that great in a group battle. One man. Should have been easy to manage now. No! Oh god, he almost grabbed us. Hate that grab so much. Takes forever. Alright. We're in here. Doing our thing. Nah, it's the same. But with that magic hair, we actually already ate it and got a nice little perk. If you look on the bottom left, we have 2 fire scrolls in green. And that's because we picked them up from the magic tree. So, whenever we go to an altar, or start a level over, or just for the first time even. We'll start with 2 fire scrolls. Unlike the crappy store brand ones that are limited use. Feels pretty nice, because fire is a really useful enchantment.
appreciate that. We also acquired the skill that's better than downward stabbing. If we knock this guy out of standing, he just gonna kill him. But we picked up this fun little quick draw skill here. That does pretty decent damage. You can get a couple of those now. Just pop Super Saiyan real quick, clean this mess up, hopefully. And yeah, clean our sweet, sweet juicier lilies. Ow. Oh god. Ran out of time. We'll go ahead and use our last free enchant here. While he chucks rocks at us. Missed that dodge. But luckily. Oh god. Another reason blocking's real good, as you saw there, something we'll be using a lot in this run. If you take damage that's more than your stamina can take while blocking, it still doesn't go into health damage. Instead, you're just kind of knocked out of stamina and slightly incapacitated for a moment. Now, if that Cyclops capitalized on it, we'd probably be dead, but fortunately he did not, so it's still useful. But hey, we did it, you know? So can't complain. It's a bit rough, but eh, we'll take it. And with that, hopefully, you see this recording, which means nothing else went wrong. Oh, man. We collect our little rewards here from Team Ninja mascot over there. And, yeah. Hopefully, we'll keep this going. So, till next time, guys and gals. And plant people, and dogs, and aliens, and...